Fao Seni, my regular analyst on the program, will be joining me this morning via the network to do some analysis on the top stories here. So let's begin this morning. We'll start with this day newspaper. And the first headline here says, who will save the Naira? Manufacturers cry out, want preferential FX allocation. Edo APC Gubo primaries crisis claims Uzodinma party picks Autumn as a replacement. Tinubu requires more time to perform. Gowon pleads with angry Nigerians. And Kwara PDP protests EFCC detention of ex-governor Hamad. And now let's go to another newspaper this morning. Let's take a look at the Daily Trust newspaper this morning. Now the headline here says Ondo cleric orders to die by hanging for robbing nine. And still here in Daily Trust, no going back on nationwide protest. Labour replies DSS. And the Labour Party breaks silence on Abure's arrest. Fingers Apapa's loyalist. Hardship federal government move to relaunch direct cash transfer targets 12 million Nigerians. Now to the Vanga newspaper. Now Hardship DSS NLC in face of over planned protests. And Naira may further depreciate by 35% in 2024, says IMF. Great luck, businesses. Others lose 100 billion naira monthly as petrol tankers containers occupy Apapa roads. That is in the Vanguard newspaper. And 4 months withheld salaries have been paid to ASU, says the federal government. APC NWC drop Uzodinma, appoint Autumn to conduct primary in Edo. And now in the Punch newspaper, TUC NLC split as DSS wants Labour against planned protests. Bank sell 172 million as CBN EFCC battles currency speculators. Edo APC welcomes rerun after controversial government primary. And still in the Punch newspaper, 10 billion naira fraud EFCC to arraign ex-Kwara governor Friday. TUC NLC splits as DSS wants Labour against planned protests. And local government chairman Abure arrested for attempted murder. Says the police, that's in the Punch newspaper. Reps asked law schools to reverse 60% fee hike. That's in the Punch this morning. Hachi Buhanese asked Tinubu to implement 2014 confirmed recommendations. Obi decries a rising exchange rate for cargo clearance. And now let's go to the Guardian newspaper. Customs 5 trillion naira target threatens trade, heightens price crisis. Petrol queues spread nationwide as Ipman Miman blames supply disruption. And also in the Guardian now, federal government AfriZimbank signed $1 billion pact for health sector development. Gowon urges ECOWAS to lift sanctions against Burkina Faso, Mali, Niger. And here we also have another news. It said U.S. to support Nigeria to boost food security, reduce post-harvest losses, says Envoy. In the nation's newspaper, Labour Party chair Abure, 5 others arrested for alleged attempted murder, illegal firearms possession. 12 million more Nigerians to get direct cash transfer. NLC reject DSS warning to shelve planned protests. Federal government workers get 4 months wage awards. And finally here, give Tinubu's reform more time. Gowon pleads with Nigerians. Now, these are your headlines this morning. Let's move straight now to look at the top stories, the top stories making the rounds in the nation this morning as I connect with Rufai Hosseini. for the analysis. Thank you for joining us this morning. We are the voice of the people, 90.3 FM. We're streaming live right now on YouTube, so you could go watch us on YouTube, subscribe to the channel, be part of our growing community. I have Rufai Hussaini on the line with me. Good morning to you, sir.
Bless you, Mary. God bless you. Okay. God bless all of us.
Yeah, thank God. It's another beautiful day. To start, there are lots of interesting stories this morning. Let's start with Edo State, Edo APC Gubba Primaries, the crisis. They claim that Uzodinma didn't do a victorious job. Now the party has picked Autumn as a replacement, and they are going to have another primary to pick the best candidate. I also have Oshiomhole also talking about the things happening there and taking sides. I'd like to get to
Edo is fast becoming the heart of new political violence, and that's the sad reality. We also have people were upset, or there was a strong disapproval that met the conduct of Governor Hope Uzodinma. And Bassi Otu of Cross River State has been pulled in to be able to save the situation. Let's see how he saves the situation. Because how can you have an election, a primary election, where you have three, you know, winners that emerged? So at some point, this was the APC that was saying, no, the team, the announcement made by the, what's it called, part of the convening team, that's the Uzodinma team, is going to be the authentic announcement. But the party, after meeting yesterday, and they knew it was going to be a show of shame for them, they came back and said that this is inconclusive and they removed Uzodinma. So let's see how this pans out. But some people are saying that it's Oshiomhole that is causing all the fracas. Oshiomhole has denied it. The Saint Louis does not believe in zoning. But I'm shocked that he said that. Because that the APC always say zoning when it favors them. But now, it's not zoning. This was the same Tinubu that said doesn't believe in zoning. This was the same Tinubu that was shouting, Yoruba, no come. Is that not zoning? So you wonder the hypocrisy of our politicians. Maybe because Adas Oshiomhole wants to get his way there and he's not getting his way. So that's what's happening. But apart from that, are you seeing what the meltdown happening in the Labour Party? And it's very sad what the Labour Party has become. Accusations made by Splendor, in Ebonyi, accusations made by McGeeve, accusations made by Murphy. You know, three people said that Abure forged their signature. You know, we don't know what really caused the Abure arrest, because police have not said anything, but they said there was a petition. Emmanuel Agmo Kenneth was saying that it's Olumide Akpata that is involved. Olumide Akpata has released a message this morning saying that he's very upset as that. I mean, VO News did carry that message. So it's exclusive on VO News. Olumide has responded. And it's just a sad indication of the sad reality of our country as we speak. But also, hope you know that the truth has to be said. The PDP too are having theirs today. They're having their primaries today. And the PDP, you know, hitherto had been in disarray. Some of the members had said they were not happy about the screening process hitherto and not everything. And secondly, the funny thing is that another party member, an aspirant in the PDP, has gone to court too, that they should stop this primary they're about to hold today. That the national secretariat, the secretary, national deputy national secretary that announced the date of the primary, had been removed by a court. That's Mr. Setonji Kodesho. Had been removed by a court. So there's already a legal case that might be impeding the PDP's own party primaries today in Edo. So it's just a case of what my very good comedian Jaguar we say it's a case of yam pepper scatter ishuatan yoron yoron. That means everything don't scatter be that. That's what Jaguar's famous word, the popular Nigerian comedian.
Yeah,
so it's just that's why I say Edo is becoming a place of political toggery. Properties were damaged in the AP secretariat. There's been fight in the Labour Party. Labour Party chairman, as we speak to, has been arrested with Abure and the youth chairman, leader of the party. And you are also having this court case with the PDP. So the three major political parties in those states are fighting.
You know, from the nations now, I can see that they said Abure and others were arrested because they arrested them for attempted murder and illegal possession of firearms. and also got a report this morning.
They arrested, they met a shotgun with about 3 rounds in their hand when they arrested them. But the truth has to be said that it's not a case of they were arrested for murder, because when they interviewed the police spokesperson, I think his name was Tijani Momo, he said that they cannot say the reason they have been arrested, but it was based on a petition that they are acting on. That's what he said. So I would like to, you know,
put that out there. But the way it was handled, other people were saying,
they said that. I mean, Abure should not have been treated that way anyway, but the police were saying because he resisted arrest and all of that, you know. But even at that, the police should do better. So, and they said they met them with firearms. So let's see how it pans out. But Abure also has his rights in courts and all of that. So, I mean, it's just a very messy one for Labour Party and all the political parties. And that's why Nigerians increasingly don't go to votes. Because look at the political process. These are the people that want to solve the problem. They can't even solve their own internal party problems. Eh? But I also enjoy Nigerians. You need to go and perform your civic rights. But we need a better set of politicians. I don't know. It's the worst among us that get into politics. And the game becomes very dirty. And look at it now. Yeah? It's just sad.
It's quite sad, though, what's happening in Edo State. Let's see how all of that pans out as APC will hold their primaries again. Now, in the news this morning, we see here that concerning the hardship, DSS, NLC in face of over planned protests. Once you have 2UC and NLC not agreeing, it says that the Department of the State Service, DSS, has asked organized labor to shelve its planned nationwide protests over the high sundry issues in the country in the interest of peace.
Would you respect DSS to stop this cheap blackmail on the NLC, please? When kidnappers were rampaging estates in Abuja, we didn't hear this kind of activity from DSS. Why is it that all of a sudden now people want to protest about things you have felt shelter? No. But to stop all of this, all this just is ensure protection of lives and property. That's just all. Why we write those protests now?
Now, let's see how the NLC and the planned protest, let's see what's going to happen, since even TUC is not with NLC on this one. Let's see how.
As usual, TUC has been one of the biggest problems. And I don't know, but for me, under Mr. Osifo, I don't know, the TUC has just not taken a position on anything. And it's very sad. I mean, the last time the TUC had leadership, as far as I'm concerned, was one of my very good friend and brother, Peter Esele. Since Esele left, forget TUC. I'm sorry. Mm. With due respect, I say those words. It's been a joke. Mm. Since Esele left, forget TUC. I mean, I've had the chance to interview my brother Osifo many times on TV, and I've had the chance to post most of his arguments and, you know, take it pound for pound on those arguments, and they're not strong enough. This was the same TUC now. They were the first to pull out and say, okay, let's wait for the government to pay wage awards. Since today, the government didn't pay wage awards. So the kind of hanky-panky TUC, please, I'm sorry. Since Peter Esele left TUC, I'm sorry. And that's why Peter Esele is still always going to be a reference point as regards TUC presidents. I'm not saying it because I know him, but the facts are there and they don't lie.
Yeah, I will speak facts. Now, another story here, now that you talked about the wage award, in the nation's newspaper, it said federal government gets 4 months wage awards. It said the federal government workers have been paid the 35,000 naira wage award for
4 months. And it's because NLC said they wanted to go on strike, with the same strike that TUC said they don't want to be part of. That's how they could get this wage award out. This was a wage award promised since last year. TUC said, NLC, don't go to strike. Let's give government a chance. Government didn't pay it. Until when NLC said they were going on strike, government could be paid it. So you can see the hypocrisy of TUC that I can't understand. And as I beg to repeat again, since Peter Esele left TUC, I'm sorry, it's just been below power leadership.
Now, let's talk about the Naira. What is happening to the Naira, depreciation of the Naira? It says here that IMF sees Naira depreciating by 35%. To 2,081 to the dollar in official market. That's what has been reported.
It's going to depreciate more. There are no fundamentals now. See, let me shock you. And you see, we keep missing the problem. Now they are trying to blame crypto traders that when crypto traders are spoofing, it's affecting. What's the volume of trade when you compare to spoofing and everything? And the reason they can spoof is because they spot a level, a pattern of weakness in your currency. All right? They spot a pattern of weakness. All right? So, you know, it's just crazy. It's just crazy, you know. The CBN has not been able to really make a very centralized system and all of that. So, it's just sad. It needs to arrest the market. And that's why you need to remove the hot air from the hot air balloon first by looking for money, injecting good dollars into the system, calm down the markets, have what we call a market reset, then now start to build fundamentals. That was what we told Baba Emilokan. That's what we told him when he came in. Don't float. Calm down the market. Get fundamentals right. He went ahead and he floated. You can see it now.
It's an interesting place to be in.
Maybe they tell them. Yeah, our mouth is smell.
Interesting place to be in.
Yeah, no. I not get close up. We can still brush mouth too, but I know. My mouth is smell.
And another news here, former president of the country, Gowon, has said that Tinubu requires more time to perform. So Gowon pleads with angry Nigerians that he requires.
I'm sorry, I'd like to disagree with Ayakun Gowon. What is more time to perform? And he was trying to state during the civil war and say, oh, people said I was slow and everything. For context purposes, Gowon did not cause the civil war. The country was already encumbered after Aburi. And when the war started, all of a sudden, when Ojukwu threw this first salvo, all right? And the truth has to be said, he responded. He responded. If we had the level of leadership Gowon provided, Nigeria will not be where it is. Gowon was honest enough to put in a person like Obafemi Awolowo, a very shrewd lawyer, to run the economics of this country. And Nigeria ran a war without going into a deficit. Nigeria ran a... That's why I keep saying Obafemi Awolowo is still the best finance commissioner in recent times. And that's why people say... I just look at... Obafemi Awolowo was not a trained economist. That was when, you know what they did? I think they put up a tax system to be able to mop up money in the economy. And we ran the war without a major deficit. An entire war. So Gowon was sensible enough to put in an Obafemi. You know, it was when the war started. He needed the leadership of an Obafemi Awolowo. That was why he had to go and release him from prison. Because he was in prison when all of this happened. Maybe, Mary, we are going to dedicate days for history. Because Nigerians need to hear history. You get? He was in prison. When something broke out, he went to release Obafemi. Obafemi was in Lekki here, in prison. He released Obafemi Awolowo, and he didn't just release him. After he said, I want you to serve in the government. I need your wisdom, sir. You're an old-time politician. I need your wisdom. So Obafemi Awolowo served. And when Gowon was doing segesegesege, Obafemi Awolowo couldn't say, Obafemi Awolowo voluntarily left. That's when he gave the famous we'll meet again speech, if we are supposed to meet. Obafemi Awolowo also made very cardinal impact. You know, it was Obafemi Awolowo that pulled us out of the sterling union. Before, Nigeria was spending pounds sterling, and he brought us into the Naira, and the Naira was a strong peg against the pound sterling. It was Obafemi Awolowo that did it, that brought us out of the sterling union. You know, then we're spending what our mama we call pong ati shile, shillings and pounds. Pong kon ati shile kon. Shillings. That's what our grandmothers then used to call shillings. They couldn't call shile, they called it shile. Shile kon.
Yeah.
Pound. They couldn't call pound, they call pong. Pong kon ati shile kon. That's what we're spending then. That's the monetary union before he brought us out of that in the early 70s, and he started spending the Naira. And he brought us out and stabilized the economy to a certain extent. We fought a war, we didn't go through a deficit. So if President Tinubu has that kind of leadership in his cabinet, so Gowon should not, I know Gowon as a former elder statesman want to calm people down at peace. Yes, an elder statesman, but he should not say that, because half the kind of leadership Gowon could accept to serve with him, we have not seen that kind of leadership in Tinubu's cabinet.
And we have people like Wale Edu Cardoso and some other top people with the president. You expect strategies, you expect something different, but it seems
but how do you respect the likes of the Wale Edu and Cardoso when these were the same people that told you that the fair value of the naira is 700 and you are seeing the naira going to 2000? So how do you believe your finance minister when he told you a couple of months ago that the fair value of the naira is supposed to be 700 and the naira has gone to 2000? So what do you want to respect him for? What do you want to respect decisions for? So these are the things we are saying in terms of integrity and power. If you didn't know that you could get the fundamentals in place to put the fair value of the naira in place, there was no point talking. So
now the one that is biting hard now is this petrol queues spread nationwide
everywhere. Maybe it's as if I'm going to install that CNG. I'm going to get CNG tank and install it.
No, we want. It's not, it's not supposed to.
I hear the good thing is that you can use CNG and you can use petrol at the same time. There's a way to do the installation.
There's no power now. There's no power. So you do inverter too for. There's no power.
No, CNG doesn't need power now. CNG is gas.
I mean for no lights, no lights, no fuel. You know, businesses are suffering.
That one has crumbled. But I'm saying for cars, maybe I will go and do CNG. If I don't know, I don't know what the conversion rate is. If you go and do CNG, at least so that you at least have another alternative source of energy, because the situation with petrol will keep going up. It's also the like kind of bad leadership. So when Gowon is comparing himself with it, Tinubu, I'm just worrying what is happening. It's the same bad leadership. President Tinubu pulled out subsidy. Now you now reverse subsidy again. You are paying subsidy again. The same IMF that praised you are now saying they are paying subsidy again. Now the transport truck owners are on strike, but they've reversed the strike. So I think the scarcity should be able to peter out. I think the shock is created. Maybe about a week or two should be able to peter out, because there's no fundamentals to be able to support the strike. They have actually, except people are doing something illegal somewhere, they have actually called off that strike by the truck owners, and lifting has commenced again. So probably by weekend or next week, we should be able to peter out. I'm not sure. There's no fundamentals. There's no grouse, because the grouse has been settled by the government. And kudos to the government when they do well.
Hello, are you there? Okay. We'll go for a quick commercial break. You were saying kudos to the government. It's when you were about to praise the government that network don't want you to praise the government.
No, let me praise them so that people will hear. So kudos to the government, in all fairness, for this NATO strike thing they've been able to cover. They said they were going to show that the responsibility that the NATO people were complaining about to get the rebate of their logistical costs, and that's a good one. So I think lifting should have started again. I think this was just the panic that was caused by the initial announcement. So I think before you know it, things will fall in line about this week or next. So in this time, the government tried. I like this. This is good responsiveness. Mm. Yes.
Okay.
So there are sometimes they do good things and we talk about it. I mean, we are here for objectivity. They tried. Kudos to them on this, in all fairness.
Thank you so much, Rufal Hussain. It's always a pleasure speaking with you.
Bless you, man.
Enjoy your Thursday. So we'll go for the break now. When we return, the phone lines will be open so you could join the conversation. Keep it here. We are the voice of the people, 90.3 FM.
The award-winning pizza in the U.S. is now here in Nigeria. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Romeo, the pizza champions, and Coldberry ice cream, light in every scoop. Visit any of our outlets and feel the rich taste from the pizza champions and Coldberry ice cream at 11 Road by First Avenue, First Town, 28 at Denira Ogunsanya Street, Surulere, 13 at Admiralty Way, Lekkifish 1. Romeo's pizza and Coldberry ice cream. Romeo, the pizza champions.
Are you looking for for the perfect getaway?
Look no further than the luxurious accommodations at Airport Golden Tulip Hotel, Lagos, number 42, Muritala Muhammad International Airport Road, Lagos.
Relax and unwind in a beautifully appointed rooms featuring all the amenities you need for a comfortable stay.
Whether you're traveling for business or pleasure, our attentive staff is here to ensure that your everyday need is met. We also offer complimentary pick-up and drop-off from the Lagos Airport.
Take advantage of our state-of-the-art fitness center, outdoor pool, and enjoy a delicious meal at our on-site restaurant.
With stunning views, world-class service, and a prime location, Airport Golden Tulip Hotel, Lagos is the perfect choice for your next vacation or business trip.
So, why wait? Book your stay today and experience ultimate in comfort and luxury at Airport Golden Tulip Hotel.
For bookings and reservations, please call 0815-8003-333 or 0815-7003-333. You can visit our website at airportgoldentuliphotel.com.
Airport Golden Tulip Hotel, where luxury meets comfort. Are you aware that Iruka Online Limited installed and designed a 100,000 capacity church building? Oh yeah, we are the sole distributors of global leading brands all over the world, such as Wafde Line Array, speakers and digital amplifiers, Presenos digital mixers and studio equipment, Coswell workstations and keyboards, Fender guitars, Mapex drums, Ashdown bass combos, just to mention but a few. We offer flexible payment plan handled by our financial department with 24/7 customer care support system. You can visit our website on www.iruka.com to avoid buying fake products. You can also visit our showroom at number 36 Lagos International Airport Road beside Golden Tulip Hotel.
We understand that having no financial stability can be very frustrating as it limits your possibilities in life. So it's important that you take hold of your finances today. There are 1,001 ways you can get started. All you need is a guide. VOP has acknowledged this need and has provided a solution. Mary Onaifia Debi invites experts across various fields, and they are dedicated to helping you create lasting revenue. Join Business Around Town every week, Mondays to Fridays at 9:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. on Voice of the People 90.3 FM. Voice of the People, now you have a voice.
Entrepreneurs, are you ready? Activator HQ, an entrepreneurship development company in partnership with Voice of the People 90.3 FM, is here with the 3X Business Startup Prize. Oh yes, we are set to give out a total of 1 million naira in cash rewards to 3 lucky aspiring entrepreneurs in Lagos. First prize, 500,000 naira. Second prize, 300,000 naira. And third prize, 200,000 naira. To win, you must have an innovative and a practical business idea. To participate, log on to www.activatorhq.com/3x to submit your ideas. There will be a selection process to shortlist 10 finalists, and these finalists will present their ideas live on air. Note, the audience will vote for their preferred contestant, and experts will access and decide the final vote. How about we now? You might be a lucky winner. Visit www.activatorhq.com/3x. This program. Are you aware that Iruka Online Limited installed and designed a 100,000 capacity church building? Oh yeah, we are the sole distributors of global leading brands all over the world, such as Wafde Line Array, speakers and digital amplifiers, Presenos digital mixers and studio equipment, Coswell workstations and keyboards, Fender guitars, Mapex drums, Ashdown bass combos, just to mention but a few. We offer flexible payment plan handled by our financial department with 24/7 customer care support system. You can visit our website on www.iruka.com to avoid buying fake products. You can also visit our showroom at number 36 Lagos International Airport Road beside Golden Tulip Hotel. Iruka, never settle for less.
You are listening to your station, the voice of the people, 90.3. Do not touch it.
listening to Voice of the People 90.3 FM. You can call now and join the conversation. This is the Front Page Review. The number to call is 0700-903-903-903. Or you can send a message to our WhatsApp line. It's 0817-175-6338. Okay, that's for WhatsApp. Hello, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Yeah, good morning to you, sir. What's your name and location?
Very good morning.
Good morning to you. Good morning.
Hello?
I can hear you. Good morning.
Okay, it's raining now. I got here last time I got.
Oh, no wonder. That's great.
It's raining. I have so much respect for our former head of state, Bola Yakubu Gowon. I could remember vividly when he moved around the country with a third prayer for Nigeria. And that prayer, thank God, God heard our prayer. And the strong man, so-called Abacha, took the exit door to the grave. And since then, I thank God for him. No, it came out late because I was expecting to come on time and discuss the issue of security and economy with Mr. President, particularly what is happening in Plateau State, his state of origin. Because if you say we should excite patience with this president, good, but we want to see some things, some projects on ground that the economy can destroy you, but at this time, we are not seeing anything. So the head of state should have a very robust discussion telling the president, please, stop for us, something name, give it to Nigeria. President, Mr. President, please, tell us those names of those people. Those killing between my state and the country, please, do something about it. So it was secret discussion anyway, it was behind closed doors.
Yeah, thank
you. But I want to thank God for him. I have a much respect for him. I don't want to use the derogatory words. I want to be very sacrificial with my statement. Good morning once again.
Yeah, good morning to you, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much for calling. 0700-903-903-903. That's the number to call. And let's talk this morning. Or send in a WhatsApp message to 0817-175-6338. That's the number for WhatsApp, just WhatsApp, not calls. And you just WhatsApp. Why, you could call our regular line. Okay, let me take some of the messages here before I go back to the phone lines. I have a mayor from Ikotuegbe says, Good morning, the house. Former head of state, General Gowon, telling Nigerians to be patient with Tinubu for another 4 years is very, very laughable. I don't blame him because he is eating fat. We waited for 8 years under Buhari and nothing was achieved. Where was Gowon when rigging and killing was going on? Mr. Gowon, where are you when politicians are looting our commonwealth? Let him keep quiet. Okay, thank you very much for your contribution. Hello, good morning. Hello, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Yeah, what's your name and location?
I'm calling from Italy.
Okay, please go ahead.
It's raining here too.
Wow.
Maybe I want to just remind Rufai, who said we change to CNG, that when Buhari came to power, remember also that Buhari told us to convert our vehicle to diesel. Diesel was the cheapest then. They told us it's more economical and this and that. We established a plant then, if you can remember, for people to convert to gas. A lot of us did so. Today, people who did it are regressing. The diesel, how much is diesel now? So that is exactly what they will do. They will jump on CNG like what they've done right now. They jump on it also. They will take it beyond the reach of Nigerians. They give us excuses, direct you to one face you at one side, do what they want to do with any of these products, and then take it to where they want to take it to, and come back again, point and look at the regime, how much is the regime. So these are all these policies they are making just to deceive Nigerians. who converted to diesel. Now they can't use the vehicle. We converted them. We can't use that. You can't try it now. What is this? You can't. So that is just it. So let us just.
So this, you pick my call and you say you couldn't hear me. Well, I know maybe it has to do with the network. But thank God you can hear me now.
Yeah, thank God.
Mm. Yes. We normally say that a comeback will happen to retaining simply means the elder one forbids abuse, not argument. Goes to go on. Please, I don't want to use word that may hurt every other Nigerian. It should remain where he is and enjoy his speech. There was a time he said that the money he made, he do not know how to make use of it. Please, let you now remind Nigerian complete 8 good years that there was nothing to show for it. Please, let them remain where they are. They have been killing, slaughtering, everything, kidnapping. All those people, where are they? They could not come out to tell Nigeria, or they could not come out to find a solution. It is only now that because they see that Nigeria are beginning to get tired of their lies, of their deceit, and all those things they have been telling us. It is very, very unfair. As for NS, let them just remain where they are. There's nothing like strike. It is because the money the government gave them have finished. They now look for another way again to collect another money for this year. Mary, tell me, in all the promises, in all the things the APC has there, they are going to do for Nigeria, can you pinpoint anything for this past month? Can you tell me? They were telling Nigeria before December that NNPC will produce oil. Today is long is February. Has there been any single drop of oil? I mean, why can't they just tell us the truth? Even if there's nothing wrong, if they can just come and tell us.
I listen to the headlines news this morning, and it's a little bit funny. We keep saying I've been hearing that people have been commenting that the government who governed state the president, and he's advising or he's urging the citizens to be patient with the present government. Do you think these people are willing to help the masses with somebody like Akpabio, who is the Senate president, addressing the press, telling the world that it is the opposition party that is fueling or that is protest? What does that mean? That means the real Nigerian, it is the opposition. But those same opposition or the so-called APC members go to the same market to buy foodstuffs as expensive as it is right now. And we have been talking about this cost of or rise or inflation or whatever, rise of cost of food. If the people here in the north go to the farm to do what they are supposed to do, if you cannot improve on the security of lives and property in the north, things will always go up. I hope for the best. God bless Nigeria.
Thank you very much. I appreciate you. Thank you for your contribution. 0700-903-903-903. Let me take some messages here, a few of them. Good morning, Mary. NLC have for a long time now doing us the most. The more you look, the less you see. If Labour don't get it right this time around, just forget about the situation forever. But it's unfortunate that their leader will go and drink tea in Aso Rock and come out to call of the strike. And for Abure, I'm seeing a monkey hand in Labour Party. This issue looks like a case of intimidation being gingered by some people. The police should do a thorough investigation and avoid being manipulated by a party. From HRHBC, Nwoko Inoshodi. Thank you very much for your contribution. Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah.
Good morning, Mary.
Good morning to you, sir. What's
yeah, this
name?
Is Mr. Richard. Yeah, Mr. Richard from Germany.
Okay.
About Gowon telling Nigerians to calm down and give Tinubu a while. I think this Gowon, he did the same thing under General Buhari. He made the same plea several times and nothing happened. These people, they don't tell Nigerians the truth, mostly the elites. They are just on themselves. It's per circle. They just gather together, make some decisions, come out and, dish out some news, and that is it. And the Nigerians will calm down, because they know that Nigerians will calm down no matter what, because of our differences in the language, in religion, in tribe, and this and that. That's why they're doing that. They say the same thing. They use this, division, ethnic and religion, harming Nigerians. So lastly, your guest, Rufai, made a misinformation.
Hello? Okay, I can hear you now. I guess it's the network. You could call me back. You still have some minutes before you round off the conversation. Okay, hello, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Yeah, good morning to you. What's your name and location?
Yeah, this is Mr. Monday calling from Lagos.
Okay, Mr. Monday, go ahead.
Yeah, you see, I don't think that this government can keep us to 4 years, because everything now is I don't know, but only God. Yeah.
Thank you very much. I appreciate you for your contribution. Okay, hello, let's take this one. Hello, good morning. Hello, good morning.
Hello. Yeah, sorry, just a minute. The network got, the Rufai said that Ojukwu fired first. No, the one fires first, from Obudu, Cross River, because he wanted to invade Biafra from.
Think we're having a bit of network where you are, network issues, but thank you very much for your contribution this morning. Okay, 0700-903-903-903. Let me go to YouTube and take a few of the messages that we have here. Let's see. We have Advance Adam says, good morning, people. Ola Adewale said, truth be told, things are not looking up due to our non-participation in governance, and we let the ill-experienced Kumasi functional OFON handle our matters. What a shame. Thank you for your message. De Franklin Dixon said, when political parties present the worst of us to rule the rest of us, the result is the present hardship, starvation, poverty, and high exchange hitting the people hard. We must pick competence over tribe. Thank you very much for your contribution. Aquila John says, go one should not tell those hopeful words. This was the same thing he said during a Buhari regime. Thank you very much for your message. I would take hello, good morning.
Hello, Mary, good morning.
Good morning to you, sir.
Good morning, Mary.
Good morning, Chief Aloy.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, Chief Aloy from Mafuluku. I can hear
hello?
You. Hello? Hello, Chief. I can hear you.
Chief Aloy from Mafuluku, Chief.
Okay, go ahead.
Are you hearing Chief Aloy from Mafuluku, Chief?
Okay.
Okay. What I'm saying is, you are trying for your work. And we were trying. But I want to know after you Google it to know whether I do it. That this. So, last meeting when they go for Aburi, Ghana. Now, this go for Ojukwu. I don't go to the meeting. Now, the Wahala fact. Ojukwu tell us Aburi must fight. The meeting when they go, they must do the thing when they talk. As they come Nigeria, they no one talk the truth. The Wahala don't fight. If you go out and talk, make you remember Aburi. No, we are not a stupid people. We are not a fish. If the only thing when they talk as a former governor, as a former president, they have to talk something when something happens. Now, Tinubu don't give up money. You don't get the talk, German guy who live in Tinubu, say this people that die, hungry, they kill people.
Thank you, Chief Alon.
Remember Aburi. I'm telling Nigeria, make them remember Aburi.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much, Chief Aloy, for your contribution. You said, well, I don't give Tinubu don't give her money. There's no place that says that he has given him money. He just spoke, advising Nigeria to be patient. That's what he says. But there's no evidence to say that Tinubu gave him money for him to say that. So we have to correct that. Thank you very much, Chief Aloy, for your contribution. And thank you to you for being part of the program this morning. I know it's raining out there, so stay safe. It's going to be a cool weather at the end of the day. I just hope we'll not have case of flood, because the one that happened, I think last 2 days ago, we'll have over 150 homes were submerged. I hope nothing of such happened this time. So take care of yourself. Next is Odindigbo on Knife at the B34 Business Around Town. Keep it here. We are the voice of the people, 90.3 FM.